So here we are at Witten Woods High School with good news. The Loveland Tigers victorious over the previously undefeated Witten Woods Warriors 7-6 tonight. Coming into this game, this was easily the biggest football game the Loveland Tigers have seen in my past 5 years of reporting for them. A very even matchup. 6-0, 6-0. Division I recruits on both sides. Three Division I defensive recruits for the Witten Woods defense alone, and one of those being Daniel Cage. He gets to decide where he plays football next year. He's getting looked at by Ohio State, and he already has already had scholarship offers from schools like Florida and Vanderbilt. So let's talk a little bit about the Loveland Tigers tonight. First, I'm going to give a shout out to Evan Burig. Great special teams all year. Tonight he had a punt 34 yards, put it right on the 1 yard line. Beautiful job by him. And how about that Loveland creativity on offense? You saw Drew Plitt even get in the game with a punt, surprising Witten Woods. The Muddle Huddle, which we'll talk about a little later with head coach Fred Cranford, and putting Alex Hesse at running back for one of the plays. What this does is this shows defenses that are going to play Loveland in the future that they have no clue what they're going to see, because it's a different Loveland offense every single week. Obviously, you're going to see the reliance on Nate Slagle and Luke Waddell at running back, but aside from that, Loveland sure has a lot of tricks up their sleeve. But the highlight of the game, the absolute highlight, was the Loveland defense. Mike Weber, Jake Janad, Darren Sackett, Brian Pop, Charlie Lawler, fantastic game. And I'll give a special shout out to Bowen Goo for finishing the game by getting that interception in the final seconds. Great job to all of them, holding one of the best offenses in the state to just a touchdown. Great job for the Loveland defense. And this shows, this game, this is so important because it shows that Loveland can win against teams that are some of the best in the state. Does this mean that Loveland can win the state championship? I don't know. But after tonight, I believe the Loveland defense certainly can. Next week, I'll see you at home. Loveland Tigers take on Walnut Hills. This game has a little bit of a storyline behind it, because last year, Walnut Hills took on the Loveland Tigers. Walnut Hills was a huge underdog, but Walnut Hills won and took the Loveland Tigers' playoff hopes for that season. So a little bit of revenge in that game next week. I'll see you there. I'm Ricky Mulvey, reporting at Witten Woods High School for Loveland Magazine.